So your producer, Mike.
Yes.
Is a very strange, scary man.
Yes.
He's responsible for the hippo ring, and thereby kind of responsible for the hippo lantern core thing.
Yeah.
Well, he confirmed my mailing address last week and said, I'm going to send you a thing. And of course, that made me afraid. And then the thing came.
Yes.
And it's this thing.
What the hell is that?
It's apparently this is a thing on NCIS, that show on CBS about the Navy and crime, and
it's a bondage hippo.
It's a bondage hippo. That was my original reaction too. I was like, holy crap, you sent me a fetish hippo. But it gets so much worse because this hippo does a thing with its butt. This is a flatulent bondage hippo. And Mike sent me this in the mail. And it's a puppet.
Hello.
And Mike sent me this. So thanks, Mike. I do not watch NCIS, but apparently this is a thing on NCIS, so there we go.
This is also the show that told you you can stop hackers faster if you put three people on the same keyboard.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well.
Yeah. Yeah. Great okay. show. Great show. So.
Well, I have a hippo from that show.
That farts.
Yes, and has a little bondage collar.
Yes, it does.
Thank you, Mike.
Okay, are we ready to do... I have a fucking farting hippo. Are we ready to do this?
Yes.
All right, let's see. Get the intro going each week. Today, please. There we go. Each week, Catherine goes out on the worldwide interwebs, finds all sorts of horrible things, and brings them back here in a little segment we like to call... What the fuck is wrong with you? And, okay. This first one is innocuous enough. Well, alright, in terms of the stories we do, it's relatively innocuous, I guess. Here it is. It's woman accused of giving alcohol to a child. Which, you know...
That's innocuous?
Look at our subject matter.
Well, I mean, I shouldn't talk, because... Yeah. My parents always gave us booze.
Yeah, but the reason I say is you're like, well, she gave him booze. Okay, it shit happens. Well, no. It gets worse.
Could I have the link?
Oh, that's right. You need that, don't you? Link.
Give me the link.
Don't do that, please.
Don't. Is this better or worse than disembodied orgasm hippo?
Yes. Anyway. From Fort Myers, Florida, a 30-year-old Fort Myers woman was arrested on Saturday after police say she admitted to Fort Myers police she gave a 1-year-old child drinks from an alcoholic beverage. Okay, I'm not seeing the weirdness here yet. Well, we're getting there. Police say they received a call from a woman requesting assistance. The woman disconnected the phone quickly. When police called back, the woman stated there was no emergency. When they got there, Laquita Neal, who I've got to get... Oh, there's her picture. She's going on the big screen because she don't seem right somehow. Girl don't seem right. Laquita Neal was identified as the woman who requested police. Neal told officers... that her brother slapped her in the face and twisted her arm behind her head after she provided the child with a, quote, sip from wine cooler she had been consuming. Due to Neil's admission, she had provided the child with an alcoholic beverage. She was arrested and charged with child abuse.
All right. One. Sip from a wine cooler is not going to kill a kid, but yes, the police kind of have to arrest you for that.
Yeah.
Of course, if they arrested my parents every time we got a sip of something, they would still be in jail. Two, one sip of wine curler ain't gonna kill a kid, so maybe you don't need to beat the crap out of your poor sister over it. You asshole.
Yeah, seriously. Just wham! Why? It's a sip from what? But yeah,
and wine coolers are barely even booze.
But to call the police and then call back and say, no, everything's fine. Everything's fine. I'm fine. How are you?
Yeah,
that just all around a general failure cloud just circling this entire Thanksgiving's going to be fun in their house this year. Okay, what's...
It doesn't start a precedent. My parents used scotch on our gums when we were teething instead of... I'm sorry, someone in the channel is saying, oh, it starts a precedent, that's the problem. No. Actually, what it did for me, the fact that my parents would always give us a sip of their drinks, was it demystified alcohol, so that by the time I got to college, I didn't spend my freshman year a drunken, puking, pantyless mess. Because it wasn't that big a deal. Well, because my parents didn't make a thing of it.
Let's be honest. Someone's got to be the drunken, puking, pantyless mess. I mean, if it's not you, then someone has to.
Yeah, the kids whose parents were like, alcohol is bad, and if you have one drink, you're going to die.
Somebody's got to do that. That's college. Someone has to fill that role. All right. This one comes from Norcross, Georgia. And it is, please say a burglar signed into a Facebook. Listen to me. Oh, the YouTubes and a Facebook. Police say a burglar signed into Facebook from a computer inside a home before he broke into before sprinting from the scene. Gwinnett County Sheriff's Office said Trevor Jones, 34, was the burglar. Wasn't hard to ID him. Harder part is finding him as warrants were issued for his arrest. According to the incident report, Jones backed his silver Ford Taurus into Stephanie White's driveway when she went out for a walk. When White returned, she saw the car in the driveway, the windows down, engines running. She entered the home the garage and called out. Hearing no one, she snagged a wallet with Jones's parole card and driver's license and his car keys from the open car. We're running up the street to our neighbors. After White confronted Jones in the driveway, he ran before swimming across a small pond in the subdivision. Once across, Jones broke into another house.
To check Twitter?
Yes, they were pools of water scattered upstairs and wet clothing she thought were used by the burglar to dry off. From the couch, he signed into Facebook. Jones suggested it was to deactivate his account. Oh, how you fail, let me count the ways.
This is not the first of these stories I've heard. I've actually heard a few of these, and I don't get it. Like, I mean, why don't you just leave a picture and your address and some DNA?
Well, it's he left his car! Running with the windows down with his wallet in it in
okay,
front
so
of the house.
Things, never mind.
What?
That's right. You're right that he did those things.
Yes!
I just.
Everything but the DNA, and let's hope he didn't. Dear God, let's hope he didn't.
Well, no, your car is bound to have some of your DNA in it.
Yeah. Yeah. Just. And he looks like. The picture of this guy here, put him on the screen.
But there's so many stories about burglars, like, checking their Facebook and shit, or taking pictures on someone's webcam and leaving them, and...
The look on his face is like, what did I do?
There's such a thing, like, the internet has become such a pervasive part of our lives that we don't even fucking get that if you check your Facebook at someone else's house, you're gonna get arrested. If you're a burglar and they didn't, like, tell you that you could use, you know, obviously.
Yeah.
Like, we're so fucking addicted.
But to use the Facebook
like, oh my god, I just stole me a stereo. I gotta tweet this.
To do it while breaking and entering.
Yeah.
Because it's not like the cops could check that. It's Facebook. I had it set to private.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, now it's down the rabbit hole time, and I'm sorry. I already have to apologize for the story because this is... All right.
Do you?
I do. Many men, their ultimate fantasy
That's not a good start.
Is, of course, the three-way. The sex with two women at the same time, that's men are all about. Well,
why do you do that to the channel?
Here's what happens when this is kind of a be careful what you wish for sort of situation. And yes, it's Florida. Threesome goes wrong. East Naples man accused of attacking wife and other woman. A sexual threesome turned violent Sunday, resulting in an East Naples man's arrest, accused of punching his wife, swinging a big screen television at her, and whipping her with a belt. Now listen to why. Listen to his reasoning for this. The man's name is Jorge Daniel Silva, 22. And he said he became jealous when the two women started kissing and wouldn't allow him to join.
Okay, so
someone missed the fucking point.
Well, also, I mean, proportionate response.
I know, right?
If you're a little jealous that you're not getting to play along, the proper response is not to start fucking swinging giant televisions.
I know!
Because now you're not invited to the threesome and you have no television and you're going to jail.
Because yeah, that's kind of pointing out. We really don't need you, guy. We really don't. You'll be in jail. We'll probably still be having sex, and we'll just get a new TV that you can't watch. You can't watch the sex or the TV when you get out of jail, because
right.
I mean, Jesus Christ, what did he expect was going to happen during a threesome? It is implied that there are three people interacting, not two people interacting on one person. It's a triangle. It's, you know, three sides.
I love that you're explaining to your audience how a three-way works right now. So I'm just going to sit back and let you do that.
Well, all right, let's think about this. This is every man's fantasy. Every guy wants two women to have sex with at once.
Every across the board, comes with the Y chromosome.
Go to any college in America today and ask every man what he wants most sexually, and he will say two women at once.
Okay.
But you see, here, the problem is what they want, what they think they want, is two women all up on top of him. Not actually, you know, involved, because, hey, those other two people, they might find each other pretty interesting during the whole affair. You gotta roll with that! Not swing a television like a baseball bat! You know? You gotta... They might want to do some interesting stuff with their fiddly bits. Yours might be left out for a little bit. Just sort of enjoy the ride. Don't get a TV and start swinging like your Manny fucking Mota.
Manny Mota. Why did you go to Manny Mota?
Airplane. It's stuck in my head for all eternity.
Wait.
Pinch-hitting Manny Mota. That airplane.
Not Mark McGuire, nope. Not Joe DiMaggio, nope. Not...
Airplane, stuck
any
in my head.
Any famous baseball player.
Airplane, stuck in my head forever. That one bit from Airplane.
Okay.
Speaking of airplanes!
Uh-oh.
Let's see, if Firefox will behave itself. Yeah, here we go. So, this...
Speaking of Firefox!
Yeah. This is from LaGuardia Airport, New York. Pilot
Strong Island.
I wouldn't be too fast to be proud here. Pilot locked in laboratory.
I say that with pride, sir.
Pilot locked in laboratory causes unnecessary terror scare.
I heard about this.
A pilot who accidentally locked himself in the bathroom of his LaGuardia-bound plane caused a terror scare last night when a helpful passenger with an accent tried to come to his rescue. Now, what happened was the door broke. The pilot couldn't get out. So he's screaming, "Hey, help!" And a man who happened to have a foreign accent came up to the door and said, "Okay, yeah, what? What you need there, buddy? I help you out. No problem, yay?" So he comes up to the door, and the guy on the
other side... That's not a foreign accent. That's Minnesota.
Well, that's virtually foreign.
No, it's not. That's in the United States.
You need to refresh your video real quick. Restart. Come on. Come on, you bastard. So, have you ever been to Minnesota? It's another country. I'm waiting for you to come back. As this guy said, "Okay, well, what can I do? Well, here's my security code, and you can give it to the co-pilot to let him know what's going on." So the guy said, "Oh, okay, yeah, I'll do that." And he goes up to the cabin, and he talks to the co-pilot and says, "Oh, hey, yeah, guess what? Your pilot buddy, he's locked in the cabin there, so he's in the bathroom. He's not coming out, you know." And the co-pilot said, "Oh my God, it's a foreign person! Land the plane! Land the plane! It's Al Qaeda!" "No, no, I got the security code from the guy. He told me it's a 12345, same as on his luggage." And the co-pilot said, "No, you're Al Qaeda!" And he forced the plane to land because the guy had a foreign accent.
And they don't even say what kind of foreign accent, do they?
They don't.
It could have been like French,
English, Irish, perhaps? Scandinavian.
Like, it could have been fucking film brain outside that door. Like, hello?
Yeah, it could have been fucking film brain.
It's me, Harry Potter. Do open the door.
They gave you that security code for a reason. If a guy is giving you the security code, stands to reason, the pilot gave it to him. What, do you think he was in there in the toilet torturing the pilot for his security code and then just ambled on over and said, "Okay, let us in there"?
It is possible that when the pilot left the cockpit, something went down and he gave the code under duress and blah, 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 blah. But there's got to be ways to, there should be a way to check that without causing, like, an incident.
Yeah. Land the plane, they call it, and it even has a recording here where it confirms that the guy, and here, this is a quote from the recording. "The captain disappeared in the back, and, I've got to do this right.
The captain disappeared in the back, and, I have someone with a, thick foreign accent trying to access the cockpit. What I'm being told is he's stuck in the lavatory, and, someone with a thick foreign accent is giving me a password to access the cockpit."
He had to say it twice.
Thick foreign accent.
Yeah.
What he was really meaning was, a brown person wants to talk to me!
Well, but how do you know they're a brown person? He didn't open the door.
True. Hey. It's just, dude. Alright, I understand working in the airline industry. You're a little jittery. I get it. But come on. You had these security measures in place. Go ahead and accent. Deal with it. You're being very quiet.
I'm sorry. I mean, it's dumb to cause a huge incident over it, but like I said, I mean, it is possible that code could have been given under duress, so I see him being a little cautious, but there's got to be another fail-safe in that process. Like, I don't know. I think a lot of airline security is sort of designed to make you feel safe instead of make you safe. So, yeah. You know, a lot of it's just kind of bullshit that doesn't actually do any good.
Everyone's already reacting to the next story I have up. Sadly.
Oh. Well, you said I was too quiet, so I started talking.
Schaumburg, Illinois, a suburban teacher was arrested on bail Wednesday night after allegedly confessing to fondling himself in class. Paul LeDuc, 75, was fired from Schaumburg Christian School on Friday after a student reported to another teacher. I love how the whole little horror just got worse on your face. To another teacher at LeDuc, appeared to be masturbating while seated at his podium during class. LeDuc was arrested Monday and charged, if the screen will reload, there we go, thank you, with felony sexual exploitation of a child. His bond was set as $40,000. I don't want to say nothing. I don't want to say anything, LeDuc said after posting bail.
No, you don't.
Prosecutor said LeDuc admitted to the act, and Schaumburg police said he might have been doing it for the past 10 years or more.
Awesome.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
But his defense attorney said LeDuc might be suffering from dementia and just repeated the allegations detective has leveled at him during questioning, which isn't better.
No.
Because now...
Old Gray Mercy ain't what she used to be. Ain't what she used to be.
My father has Alzheimer's. He has dementia. It's not, you know, I mean, they're not, you know, you don't become an un-person, but teaching probably is no longer the job for you because your brain is deteriorating.
But you see, just the idea that he was just sitting up there.
And it's also not a great defense because if he's suffering from dementia, there's a possibility that he was doing that because he'd forgotten where he was or was hallucinating because that happens.
Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois has a wide range of health insurance plans.
That is the best possible outcome.
It honestly is, because then he's not a pervert, then it's just a very sad story about someone who's ill, and, you know, hopefully they get him the help he needs. If he's not suffering from dementia, then fuck that guy. And, yeah, you know, Christian school on top of it, so awesome, which means he wasn't teaching sex ed, obviously.
Hold on one second, the entire channel is losing its fucking mind.
There's an ad playing, apparently.
Okay, there we go. Now it's muted. Shut up. Good Lord, they're like, anyway.
Yeah, I don't, I mean...
Yeah, the idea of...
And yet, there's always the gross teacher at the school. Like, everybody has a story about that one teacher who was just kind of gross, skeezy, and... kind of obviously in it for the young people. I won't be gender specific. Usually that teacher wasn't, you know, jerking it in front of the class.
I know! Because it's like, oh yeah, Sally, what's 2 + 8? Answer me that. Oh yeah, that's hot.
I don't like that voice.
What's the square root of the hypotenuse? Tell me now.
Stop doing that voice, or I'm going to start making dolphin sounds to counter.
Seriously, that's not right. On so many levels, not right.
Yeah. Also, apparently he was teaching economics. There is nothing sexy about math. And I do not say that just because I suck at it.
This one, I have a hard time feeling sorry for.
Now they're all like, no, do the dolphin sound, do the dolphin sound.
I have a hard time feeling sorry for this guy because we have video for this one.
I don't want video, probably. I'm thinking.
Drunk zoo visitor ends up in hospital after climbing in monkey enclosure, quote, to play.
Oh, that's a bad idea.
I can't pronounce it. Yao Lit Dos Santos. I'm sorry, I suck at Spanish. Sorry. A mechanic in Sao Paulo, Brazil, admitted he had been drinking.
Portuguese, actually.
Portuguese. I suck at that, too, obviously. restart your video. It's stuck again.
Again?
Again. admitted he had been drinking alcohol when he went to the Sorocaba Zoo on Sunday, thinking it would be fun to join the zoo's colony of spider monkeys. He climbed over a fence and swam across a dividing pool to get closer to the animals. And here's the point where we're going to show you the video, because it's kind of awful, yet kind of hilarious. And when I'm saying awful, it's not like, it's not like, oh my god, it's awful. No, it's oh dear god, what's wrong with you? Here we go. Let's start playing. Come on, sometime today. There we go. Let's get this up on the big screen. All right, as you can see here now, he's just sort of swimming around in the water. There's the monkeys who are like, get the fuck out! It's essentially GTFO time for this guy. He's like, what? I like you. I want to be my friend. And this other monkey's like, get away from that man. You don't know where he's been. Get off! No, you don't know what you're going to get. Get off of him.
What did I tell you about not talking to strangers?
And of course, the monkey bites the living shit out of him and is like, yeah, you get out of here. You get the fuck out of here. And I just, it did, okay. Again.
And he's totally putting an arm in that water, which you know is filled with, like, monkey shit.
Yes. I cut at that point. I'm like, okay.
That's not sanitary.
We've shown you all you really need to see on that one. I just, this poor, okay, the monkeys. I feel so sad for the monkeys in this. Because they're all like, what are you doing? Leave us the fuck alone. We're already stuck in here. Now we gotta deal with your drunk ass. Go home.
And when the next superbug starts, we can all look at this guy and thank him for wiping out a third of the Earth's population.
Yeah. Yeah, he got infected with the rage virus right there. Just, leave the monkeys alone. They don't want to play. They don't.
Here's the thing about wild animals. They're wild animals. Like, I actually, a few different people sent me the link this week, and I posted it to Twitter about the guy that got killed by his pet hippo. And it had video of him, like, wrestling with his pet hippo and said that he used to ride it like a horse. No!
No!
Yes, I appreciate the adorable, noble, majestic, and extremely fucking lethal hippo. They will fuck you up!
But the thing is,
they will kill the shit out of you. You don't wrestle with them.
Haven't been domesticated, is the point.
Yeah. Just because
horses, yes. Hippos, no.
Just because it's cute doesn't mean it will not fuck you up.
How drunk do you have to be to hop in that mucky ass water and go try to hug a monkey? How drunk?
Pretty drunk.
How many? I want to know how many shots until this becomes a good idea. Seriously,
like, just look at that water.
Oh god, yeah, and that's nasty.
To quote the wise Jay Baruchel in Tropic Thunder, it's like a petri dish. No,
I just whatever. This is all right. If there has ever been a wake up call for an AA meeting, it is this. This is.
You'd like to think that's bottom.
Yes. He's going to be back on the show, isn't he?
Probably.
Okay. And finally tonight, holy McJesus burgers, everything goes nanners. Hattiesburg woman punches cop after car burns at McDonald's drive-thru. Hattiesburg, Minnesota. Wow. You were talking about Minnesota. Here's Minnesota. A woman pulling through a McDonald's drive-thru around noon on Tuesday was informed that her car was in flames.
She didn't know?
Apparently not.
How do you miss that?
I don't know. Anna later allegedly assaulted a police officer at the scene. The employee working at the window of the Highway 49 location told the woman her car was smoking and it may be on fire. The driver quickly pulled away from the window and parked the burning car. Staff called the fire department. Witnesses said the driver returned to the window while the car was burning, retrieved her food, and ate it at the scene while waiting for emergency personnel to arrive.
Well, you know, she was hungry and she already paid. Might as well get your McDouble on.
Well, yeah. It gets worse, though. As fire officials were completing their report, the driver attempted to leave the property after she and her friend removed the car tag from the burned chassis.
Yeah, you can't do that.
Fire officials called Hattiesburg police the scene. When an officer attempted to escort the driver back to the presence of firefighters for questioning, she allegedly resisted and punched him.
Yeah.
However, this part gets me. She was arrested on 4 misdemeanor counts, including resisting arrest, assaulting a police officer, disorderly conduct, and public profanity.
Well, it is Minnesota.
That's a misdemeanor? I go to jail for saying fuck in Minnesota?
You should not go to Minnesota.
I should not go to Minnesota. I would never get out of jail ever.
No, you wouldn't.
Ever. But no, I just... Okay, lady, if you don't know...
She threw a McFlurry of punches. Oh, really?
Oh.
Really now?
If you can't tell whether or not your car is on fire, and in fact...
That's problem one.
It's problem
because
one.
Because if it was on fire enough to be fully engulfed minutes later, it was pretty goddamn on fire.
Yeah, what are you doing? Just turn up the air conditioner? Wow, it's hot in here for some reason. Like, Jesus, I don't understand
this. How do you not notice that? And just calmly go to the drive-thru while your car is burning.
That black smoke? No, it does that all the time. The orange flames, not so much, but I'm sure it'll be fine.
That's a thing a person ought to notice.
And you know...
Like I mentioned on my blog today that, you know, paying attention to one's surroundings is a basic survival skill an alarming amount of people seem to lack. It's a really good example of it. A little bit of attention to your surroundings would tell you something like, my car is on fire. And I should probably exit said car before I'm on fire.
If you're missing that crucial little bit of information, I love that she got the burgers and ate them while waiting for the watching the car burn. Like,
I would totally do that. You already paid for your food. You're hungry. Fucking do that. I'd be like, well, my fucking car's on fire. This is obviously going to take some time. Could I have my McNuggets, please? Thank you.
I love how she thought she was just going to innocuously walk away with the tags and like, I'm out of here. I'm scot-free. Not my fault. Yeah. You can't prove it's my car. Yeah, they can. They can.
There's like video and stuff of you.
Yeah.
And your car burning.
There, at the drive-thru. There are serial numbers on every fucking part of your car. I promise you.
But, you know, Joe Pesci said it, and he was right. They really do fuck you at the drive-thru.
Oh. Lethal Weapon, really? Really?
Absolutely. Really?
Okay, so what did we learn tonight?
Monkeys are not your friends.
They are not. They will rise up and conquer us all one day. I maintain this will happen. Planet of the Apes, it's a documentary. Study it, learn.
My army of intergalactic battle hippos will take them out with ease.
We learned that no matter how bad you want to tweet what you up to, probably not a good idea to do so during the commission of a crime.
At least not on someone else's property during the theft of said property.
And don't leave your car running in their driveway.
No. I mean, maybe he thought that was a fair trade. Like, yeah, I'm going to steal your TV, but I'm going to leave you my 96 Taurus. But no. We do not exist in a barter system anymore.
We learned that just because you're in a threesome doesn't mean it's all about you. So deal with it. And not with a large screen television.
No. If you're feeling a little sexually jilted... Just post a whiny internet rant about it. Like
that's why they made LiveJournal.
Yeah.
Come on.
Send, put out a cryptic passive-aggressive tweet and move on like the rest of the world.
Exactly.
Don't tease at people. That's not nice.
We learned just because someone has a thick accent doesn't mean they're not your friend.
That's true.
That's true. And,
we learned pay attention to your surroundings because your car might be on fire at any time.
Be on fire at any time. And we learned
that you're in the shit. Like, when you get in your car tomorrow to go to your jobs, everybody, just take a second and look around and determine whether or not your car is on fire.
It's like a flow chart, you know, is my car on fire? If yes, get the fuck out. If no, go to Starbucks. You're done. I just, but, and of course we learned your parents gave you alcohol.
Yes. Well, yeah. We already knew that. I already told the story of how I was first drunk at 6 years old. That wasn't my parents' fault. That was my sister's fault. My sister and I decided to polish off a bottle of champagne that my parents had brought home from dinner while watching cartoons while they slept, and we got totally hammered. And then went to see Annie on Broadway with Sarah Jessica Parker.
My co-host, everyone.
We had a kick-ass time at that show, let me tell you.